to everyone in the house of God and those who are watching by Facebook and the internet and YouTube. I say praise the Lord and good morning. This morning I want to open up by reading a verse of scripture in your hearing. It's found in 1 Corinthians, the 6th chapter and the 20th verse. I'm just going to read it in your hearing. And it reads, "For ye are bought with a price. Therefore glorify God in your body and in your spirit, which are God's." Before we settle into our routine this morning of waiting for the praise team to sing a song to move us, waiting for the pastor to preach a word to uplift us, instead of going through our usual Sunday morning rituals wherever you are, this morning I want to challenge you to think about God and who He is. I want to challenge you to forget about what you want. Forget about what you need. Forget about what you're going through. Forget about your issues. Forget about your problems. God is worthy to be praised. And don't you know that our sole purpose for still being here on this earth is to glorify God? And this morning, the way we started is what we're going to do one more time, just for one more minute. I know you're on Facebook, you're in your car, you're at home. We just want to give God some praise this morning. You may want to jump up and down in your bed. You may want to run your living room. You may want to run around the sanctuary. If you're driving down the street and you want to wave your hands, just keep one hand on the steering wheel. We got the praise team. We got the keys. We got the drums. We got Sister Daniels. We got Team Challenge. We got people all over the world who love God. And this morning, can we just give God some praise? Just for who He is. Come on, saints. Let's give God some praise. Just for who He is. Come on, glory. Hallelujah. We bless you, Lord. Come on, saints. Give God some praise. Go ahead. Go in. Let's praise Him.
Praise up there, because there's such a great expectation in this atmosphere. Welcome again and praise the Lord to all of you. Hallelujah. I am ready for God. Look at your neighbor and say, I'm ready for God. Whatever God wants to do, tell Him, let's do it. Praise your name, Jesus, for He is worthy. Oh, just lift up your song to the Lord and say, He is worthy. Oh, come on, everybody say, He is. He is worthy. Oh, you are worthy today, Father. You are worthy. Oh, we are worshiping You in spirit and in truth. Come on, keep the level of your praise and your worship up. We raise our worship to You, Father. We raise our praise to You, God, because we love You. We're so happy to be in Your presence. We expect, Father God, nothing less than great in who You are, Father. And so we worship You, Lord. We worship You. We worship You, Lord. We worship You. We love on You. We love on You. Oh, we worship You. give God your praise, your very best praise, and tell him, Lord, I appreciate you. I appreciate you. And I love you, God. And I need you. Than being in his presence. Hallelujah. Look at your neighbor and say, I love you. I love being around you. But there's nothing like the presence of the Lord. Oh, tell him, say, you cool, you good. But there's nothing like the presence of the Lord. There's no better place to be than in his presence. Join us in worship in this song. Listen, it's really easy. Oh, nothing like your presence, Lord. All I want is to be with you. There's nothing like your presence, Lord. All I want is to be with you. There's nothing like your presence, Lord. All I want is to be with you. There's nothing like your presence, Lord. All I want is to be with you. 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 Say there's nothing.
Nothing like
your presence, Lord. All I want is to. There's nothing like,
there's nothing like your presence, Lord. All I want is to be with you.
There's nothing like your presence, Lord. All I want is to be. Say it one more time. There's nothing like
your presence, Lord. All I want is to be with you.
Time, listen, there's nothing like your presence, Lord. All I want is to worship you. Nothing like your presence, Lord. All I want is to worship you. There's nothing like
good presence, Lord.
All I want
is to worship you.
There's nothing like your presence, Lord. All I want is to worship. You, nothing like your presence than to worship you. And I will.
gotta make it personal.
And I worship you, you.
Yes, you are.
And I worship you, you are God. And I worship you, you.
Miracles, signs, and wonders. This is what I hear in my spirit. Miracles, signs, and wonders. That's what I want to do. What God wants to do, miracles, signs, and wonder. Everybody sing in harmony, miracles, signs, and wonder. I will do them among you today. Hallelujah. Say miracles, signs, and wonder.
Miracles.
If you believe it, just raise your hand. Life in the way that things are going. Hallelujah. And God is saying to you, I will restore your hope by the end of this service. I release now to you, hallelujah, the hope of Jesus Christ to be released into your home, in your relationship, in your marriage, hallelujah, in your career, in your business, in your family. Oh, he says, I will do miracles. Oh, he's a restorer of hope. Miracles, signs, and wonder. If you believe it for that person, just begin to rejoice. Oh, sign and wonder. Oh, he'll do it for you. Oh, signs and wonder. Oh, he'll save, heal, and deliver. For my presence, say, heal. somebody prayed today. I feel you in my spirit. You said, Lord, I just need a sign that you're with me. The Lord is saying today, I give you signs, wonders, and miracles. Oh God, miracles, signs, and wonders. Oh, miracles and signs and wonders. One more time, team, say it. Say miracles, signs, and wonders. Oh, miracles, signs, and wonders. I receive it, Lord. It's the year of supernatural success. Ooh, shate ko yara masa. Eh yala mandi orobo ko shataya. And even as it is the first year of this eighth month, the first day of the eighth month, I hear the Lord saying that this will be the first day of a new beginning to you. Eight being the number of new beginnings, the Lord declares to you, you will begin again today. Hallelujah. And even as you've been seeking for this, Lord, when will this end? When will this be the end? Hallelujah. I hear the Spirit of the Lord saying, even as it is the first day of the eighth month, I will cause you to begin again, begin again, begin again, begin again, begin again, begin again, begin again. It's a new season, say begin again. No. If you praise him and you believe him for that, I need you to just clap your hands and say, Father, thank you that you have me in this moment so that I can begin again. Thank you for a fresh start. I need you to just lift up your praise. Come on, clap your hands, oh ye people. Shout unto God with the voice of triumph. For you are ready. Oh, you are ready. I hear God saying, yes, you are ready. Yes, you are ready. I hear someone saying, I'm not worthy. But God says, yes, you are worthy. Oh, if you can believe me. To begin again, hey, hey. Begin again. Miracles, signs, and wonders. We hear you, Lord. Miracles, signs. He's doing it even now. Yes, Lord, sweep through this house. Ooh, I just need you to slip your hands up in the air. There's a wave of healing that is flowing through this place. Just receive it. Open your heart and say, Father, I receive what you do in me now. Whatever you need, I need you to stretch your faith. Come on, stretch your faith. Stretch your faith, your faith. Lord, increase my faith so that I can meet you where you are. Oh, yes. Yes, 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 yes. Oh, you, those of you who are at home, I need you to just lift up your hands. Lift up your hands right on the couch. Right there while you're working. Lift up your hands. While you're driving, I need you to keep your hands on the wheel, but I need you to lift up your heart and say, Father, I receive what you're doing even now. Let your words verbalize what God is doing. He'll meet you right there on that highway. He'll meet you right in that hospital room, right in that nursing home, in that rehab center. Father, we thank you today that you want to do a new thing in us. You want to do a new thing. It's not new to you, but it'll be new to us. We thank you, God, for there is no new thing under the sun. But we just thank you today, Lord God, because you are thinking about us. Every intention that you have, Father, Lord God, is good. Hey, you're good. You're good. You're good. And so, Father, we receive your word today. We receive what you're doing today. Thank you that you heal us. Some of you have surgery scheduled. Some of you, hey, But I believe that the God of miracles is here. Ooh, would you believe with me today? You don't have to have a surgery if you don't want to. All you have to do is just stretch your faith, and God will heal you right now. Hallelujah. If you know the song all over this house, I know your mask is over your face, but just sing it.
Oh,
Rabbi.
All the honor. We give you praise. We give him glory. We give him honor. We give him thanksgiving. We lift our hearts to the Lord. Bless the Lord, oh my soul, and all. Clap your hands, oh ye people. Lord, I praise him. Give him the glory. Before you take your seat, just look around and make eye contact with three saints and tell them he's worthy of our praise. I feel like you felt, Prophetess Kavon. I feel like God want to do miracles today. In this first day of the eighth month, it is a day of new beginnings, a day of renewal, a day of restoration, a day of revival, a day of strength. And the sooner you praise him. Thank you, Jesus. The sooner you thank him. Praise him. Oh, glory. The sooner you lift your hand, don't let your burden stop you from blessing him. Don't let your worries stop you from worshiping him. Don't let your pain stop you from praising him. He's still good. He's still God. He's still good. He's still God. Tell another worshiper, look them in the eye and remind them he's still good and he's still God. Hallelujah. 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 There's no God like Jehovah. 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 There's no God. There's no God like Jehovah.
Jesus.
No God
like Jehovah.
No God.
God,
no God like Jehovah. Anybody know? There's nobody like him. Nobody like him. Nobody like him. Nobody can save me. Nobody can heal me. Nobody can turn me, turn me, turn me, turn me, turn me. No, no, nobody. No, 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 nobody. Nobody. Nobody.
He's a wonder-working wonder.
He's a wonder-working wonder. He's a wonder-working wonder. Yes, he is. He's a wonder-working wonder. A wonder-working wonder. A wonder-working wonder. Yeah, yeah, yeah. His name is Jesus. Jesus. Anybody know his name? What about y'all in the balcony? Do you know his name is Jesus? Do you know his name is Jesus? Somebody say Jesus. Say Jesus. If you love them, say yeah. Yeah. Say yeah. Say yeah. Say yeah. Say yeah. Say yeah. Say yeah. No God like, there's no nobody like it. Nobody. Shh, nobody. Everybody, just need to hear the sanctuary say, because the devil's listening to what you're speaking out of your mouth. And some of you need to declare some stuff so that by the time you get back to work tomorrow, the God that you serve will be then work everything out on your behalf. I need everybody from the depths of your spirit, say this with me. There's no God. I can't hear you, Calvary. Declare it in the atmosphere. There's nobody like him. Some of y'all cried some tears. Some of y'all lost some things. But there's still nobody like him. There's still nobody like him. There's nobody like him. No, 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 no. No, 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 no. No, 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 no. No, no, nobody like him. There's nobody like him. There's nobody like him. One more time. Nobody like him. Everybody lift your voice and say, say yeah. Yeah. Lift it up and say, lift it up and say, yeah, 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 yeah. Say yeah, 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 yeah.
Oh, thine is the kingdom and the power
and the glory. God is. God is still in the miracle working business. Elder Joe, get past the barber microphone.
Have your seat in the presence of the Lord. I want to welcome the Calvary family here in the sanctuary, the Calvary family watching around the world, and all of our guest friends and visitors who have joined us both in the sanctuary and watching online. Wherever you are viewing the service on this morning, I want you to welcome the viewing audience around the world by typing in these words in the comment section. Help me say it, church. Let's let our viewing audience know with the Calvary welcome. Tell them you belong here. Come on, tell them one more time. You belong here. Give them a big Calvary welcome with the clapping of your hands. And while we're welcoming the viewing audience, it's been a long time, but we are so happy this morning to have our friends from Teen Challenge that are seated in the balcony today. Let's welcome them back to Mount Calvary. We want you to know you belong here. Pastor Bob, we are so honored and grateful for the great work that you and the team is doing in changing lives, in advancing the kingdom agenda. I've been waiting a long time for us to reconnect on this morning. And Pastor, will you greet the church and greet our viewing audience? People are watching this morning online from around the world. And Pastor Bob, if you don't mind sharing that testimony of miracle healing that God did, I believe someone's going to receive it by faith and be healed. Give Pastor Bob a big Calvary welcome.
Praise the Lord, church. Come on, someone got to give God a hand clap this morning. Come on, Calvary, we could do better than that. Let's give a hand clap to our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, this morning. Bless his name. We bless you, Lord. We honor you, Lord. We magnify you today, Lord Jesus. And we pray today that your perfect will be done on earth as it is in heaven. In Jesus' name. Calvary family, it is so good to be in the house of the Lord today. We are so blessed on behalf of Adult and Teen Challenge Ohio Valley. Myself, my name is Pastor Bob Pavlich, and I have the honor and the privilege of overseeing our facilities throughout the state of Ohio and in Youngstown. And we're here visiting today, and we are just so blessed that we have the opportunity to worship with you, to share with you. And right down the street here in Youngstown, you have facilities for men and women. Come on, everyone knows someone struggling with drugs and alcohol, right? Whether it's a co-neighbor, a friend, a son, a daughter, the first line of our mission statement, somebody got to get this, is introduce individuals in addiction to a personal relationship with Jesus Christ. Somebody got to shout this morning. We have beds for men and women, immediate bed access availability, and God has been changing and transforming men and women's lives due to prayers and support. Bishop, from churches like this, we covet your prayers, we covet your support, and it's because of you guys that facilities like us exist. From everyone watching online, it's because of the prayers of the saints that men and women have a place to come to spend 12 months of their life, come on, cultivating a personal, intimate relationship with Jesus Christ. And we thank you and we bless you. I shared with Bishop Tyson this morning. We are talking about healings, and I just want to take 3 minutes. Somebody has to get this. My daughter was born in August of last year, on August 9th. I'm getting ready to celebrate a one-year birthday for my daughter. And my mother-in-law has been on dialysis waiting for kidneys. So my wife said, you know what, maybe I can be a match for someone. You guys know how that works. And she could give her kidneys to someone that could give them to someone so my mother-in-law could get new kidneys. And my wife went to go get checked, and the kidney doctor told my mother-in-law, your daughter's not a match because she has polycystic kidney disease. And she told my mother-in-law, 5% of people with polycystic kidney disease have brain aneurysms. Now, my wife's young. She just pushed out baby number 3. Amen? So she said to me, honey, I'm pretty positive I don't have brain aneurysms. She said, but we just want to shelf this and let's pray to God about this. And I respect my wife. Husbands, we respect our wives. We're their covering, but we pray with them. And around November, she came to me and she said, you know what? Our copay's done. Everything's paid off in the pregnancy. I think I'm going to go get checked. And we prayed about it, and she works at Mercy downtown St. Elizabeth. So she went and got a CT scan, and something popped up. And the doctor said, you need to go get a second opinion. And she knows some of the neurologists from St. Elizabeth. So we went to the brain surgery neurologist in Toledo at Mercy Health. We walked in, it was mid-December, and the neurologist looked at us and said, what were you guys told? And they said, well, there's something came up on the screen and we need a second opinion. The neurologist said, you have a 10 by 10 by 10 brain aneurysm that is requiring immediate surgery. My wife and I looked at each other and said, I have a 6-year-old at home, a 2-year-old, a newborn. It's about to be Christmas. We're trying to celebrate the birth of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. And you're telling me I'm requiring brain surgery? And they said, and here's the tough part. They did a few more tests. They told her where the aneurysm was. It's attached to her optic nerve. And they'd have to go in through her groin, move her optic nerve, put stents in, cover everything with a foil, and it's going to be a pretty intensive surgery. We need to get back to Youngstown, pack, and come right back up. So we really prayed, called upon some saints, some people to start praying for us. My wife and I looked at each other and were like, God, you've never failed us yet. By your stripes, we are healed. We start pleading the blood of Christ over the situation. And someone needs to get this, because sometimes what the world seems is impossible to God. Come on, somebody got to get this. So we spent Christmas in Toledo. She got her aneurysm surgery. There was a couple complications with the surgery. She had to stay an extra week longer. And we got back. She recovered. You know, it was about 2 months of pretty much recovery. And then after 90 days, you have to go back for an ambiogram, which is they do some tests. They put dye in your brain. And this is where it gets good to check on to make sure how the stents, everything went. Now, I'm with neurologists, brain surgeons in Toledo, and the brain surgeon came out and he said, now that this is done, can I talk to you? He said, I should not be having this conversation with you right now because this was the largest aneurysm we've ever seen, and we didn't think your wife was going to make it out of surgery. They said, she is our miracle patient, and we don't know what you guys did. But not only was this the largest aneurysm we ever operated on, he pulled up the charts. And he said, after 90 days, it's supposed to have gone down a quarter in size. Someone got to get this. Pulled up the charts, said it was gone. Come on. I don't think you're hearing me what my God did. The brain surgeons said, we don't know why. We don't know what happened. And I got to say, but my God. My Jesus, he came to heal, he came to deliver. And I stood up in that room with those brain surgeons and I told him, I know somebody who heals, who cleanses and makes whole, and I have living proof. I showed Bishop Tyson the pictures. Her aneurysm's gone, she's totally healed. Science can't explain it, doctors can't explain it, but my God had plans. And that's a testimony for someone today, that if you have faith like a mustard seed, God will heal, God will deliver, and God will bless. Praise the Lord. Amen, amen, and amen. Somebody got to shout. Come on.
Come on, grab a hold of that. Your healing is here too. If you'll praise God for her healing, rejoice with them that rejoice. Your healing is here. Where you're watching this morning, believe God. We got to take 60 seconds and give God a praise. Yeah. Only God can do it. 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 Do it, do it, do it. It's already done. It's already done. It's all. Say it. I'm saved, healed, delivered, set free. I'm saved, healed, delivered, set free. I'm saved, healed, healed. Healed in my mind, I am healed. In my heart, I am healed. In my soul, I am healed. In my body, I am healed. My family is healed. My marriage is healed. My children are healed. Grandchildren are healed. Healed, healed. Delivered, 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 delivered. You whom the Son sets free, got to be free, free indeed. Delivered from drugs. Delivered from cocaine. Delivered from heroin. Delivered from alcohol. Delivered to praise Him. Delivered to worship Him. Delivered to thank Him. Delivered to walk right. Delivered to live right. Delivered to be right. Delivered. Delivered, delivered, delivered. I shall not die. I shall not die. Live, 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 live. I want to hear a Mount Calvary praise. Clap your hands with purpose. When you clap your hands, the man of God said it summons angels. You must understand the warfare that is in your prayer. For the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but mighty. Go ahead and baptize. Go ahead and baptize. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. 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 No other name under heaven whereby men must be saved. There is no name above the name. Jesus. Jesus. My doctor. My lawyer. My king, my healer. Who do you praise? Who do we love? Who do we serve? Jesus. Not Allah. Not Allah. Not Allah. Not Allah. Not Buddha. Not Confucius. Not Laodice. Jesus. Love that name. I love that name. I love that name. I love that name. And release your praise. Give God about 60 more seconds of your best worship. Oh, praise him. Oh, bless his name. Psalm 147, verse number 3. Revelation 21, verse number 7. Hey, glory. He's a good God. Psalm 147, verse number 3. Revelation 21, verse number 7. Glory to heaven. Y'all got 30 seconds for me to testify? Well, as you know, I had my 9th surgery in the last 2 years on Monday of this week. And the doctor came in after the surgery. Say, Reverend Tyson, something you're doing is working. Because I'm here to report 100% kidney function in both kidneys.
check this out, Elder. He said, I know you've been struggling with these stents. He said, but your urine flow is so strong, I'm gonna take these big stents out. And he said, in 3 months, we're gonna take out one stent. And in the surgery after that, we're gonna take out the other stent, and you will be stent free by the end of the year. Would you? Your neighbor, trouble can't last always. There's somebody else that want to have their sins washed away. There's somebody else right now that say, Pastor Tyson, this is my day to be delivered from the bondage of sin. I want you to jump out from your seat and run down to this altar right now and let us baptize you in water in Jesus' name for the forgiveness of your sin. You don't have to leave here the same way you came. I don't care if you're in the back of the church, the front of the church, the balcony, the top or the bottom. Say, Pastor Tyson, I want to be free. I want to be delivered. I want the power of the Holy Ghost. I want to be a child of God. Just start coming this way right now toward this altar. God will meet you here. Deliverance will meet you here. Just run. Don't even walk. Just run. Don't even walk. Just start running. Just start coming. Jesus. Oh, Jesus. Come this way. Come this way. Come this way. Is there anyone else? Come right now. Come right now. Whatever you need, God has it. God has the power. I want to be baptized. I want to be filled with the Holy Ghost. I want to be a new creature in Christ. If any man be in Christ, he is a new creature. Old things are passed away. All things have become new. Oh, I think we got another soul want to go down in the water. Saints, how do you feel about it? Pastor Bob said all these young ladies are in the addiction center, but when they come up out of the water, when they come up in the name of Jesus, every addiction shall be broken, 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 shall be broken. It's got to break. Shall be broken. It's got to break. Shall be broken. Shall be broken. Shall be broken. The anointing destroys the yoke. The anointing destroys the yoke. Holy Ghost. Holy Ghost. Holy Ghost. Holy Ghost. Heal her with the Holy Ghost. Holy Ghost. Holy Ghost. Like they got it on the day of Pentecost. Holy Ghost in her soul.
Holy Ghost.
Holy Ghost.
Holy Ghost
in her heart.
Holy Ghost.
Holy Ghost.
Holy Ghost
in her mind.
Holy Ghost.
Don't just watch.
Holy Ghost.
Give him praise.
Holy Ghost.
Don't just watch.
Holy Ghost.
Give him praise.
Holy Ghost.
Don't just watch.
Holy Ghost.
Give him praise.
Holy Ghost.
Hallelujah.
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 Clap those hands and give God worship. The blood prevails.
The blood prevails.
The blood prevails.
The blood prevail.
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 Lift those hands in this sanctuary.
The blood still works.
Lift up a shout before the Lord right now. Thank you, altar evangelist. Oh, glory. Help me say, oh, glory. Wave your hand and say, worthy. Oh, 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 oh. You that are watching on the World Wide Web. Pastor Tyson, I want to be free. I want to be delivered. I want to be blessed. I want to live the life that Christ died for me to live. I want you to pick up the phone right now and call us here at the church at area code 330-747-4445. We are waiting at that phone to receive your prayer requests, to intercede unto the Lord on your behalf. Today is your day for a breakthrough and for a miracle. Won't you call us now at area code 330-747-4445. And he sets the captive free. Jesus breaks every fetter. Jesus breaks every fetter. Touch me. Sanctuary and say, oh, the blood of Jesus. Oh, the blood.
Oh, the blood of Jesus.
Let us all worship. Just every soul singing, oh,
oh, the blood of Jesus,
singing,
oh, the blood of Jesus.
Hi, Lord. I worship and adore you. I worship and adore you.
Just want to tell you.
everyone. I worship. There's power in oneness. Let's sing it in unison. I love you.
I love you, Jesus.
In unison. I worship.
I worship.
Unison.
And adore.
Unison. One voice.
Just want to tell you that I love you.
Praise God for another soul.
Lord, I love you more than you.
I just want to say.
I just want to say that I love you more than anything.
I just want to say, everybody. You to lay down your burdens. The burdens.
The burdens.
And now, my dear sister, upon the confession of your faith and the confidence that we have in the Word of God concerning His death, burial, and resurrection, I now baptize you in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ for the remission of your sins. And ye shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost.
Well, another praise for another soul. There is a stillness
in the atmosphere.
So come lay down. The burdens.
The burdens you have carried, for in the sanctuary,
God is the joy and the strength of my life.
He moves all pain, misery. Promise to keep,
never to leave me.
Never to
He's
leave
never,
never, ever.
I've got to fast and pray.
I've got to fast and pray. Stay in the narrow.
Keep my life clean.
Keep my life clean.
I want to go with Him.
I want to go with Him.
And now, my dear sister, upon the confession of your faith and the confidence that we have in the Word of God concerning His death, burial, and resurrection, I now baptize you in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ for the remission of your sins, and ye shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost.
think we ought to give God a tremendous praise for the soul that have been added to the kingdom on this morning. Have your seats in the presence of the Lord. Thank you, praise team. A word of exhortation you will find in Psalm 147 in verse number 3 and Revelation 21 and verse number 7. He healeth the broken in heart and bindeth up their wounds. Revelation 21 and 7. He that overcometh shall inherit all things, and I will be his God, and he shall be my son. How to overcome hurt. Father, thank you for just these few moments of meditation from the Holy Scripture. And may thy word and thy presence bring healing to all who are in need of a divine touch of thy Spirit. In Jesus' name, amen. How to overcome hurt. It is impossible for anyone who is a human being navigating their way through the human experience to go through this life and not experience some hurt and some pain. One of my favorite nursery songs as a child was "Row, row, row your boat gently down the stream." Somebody help me. Merrily, 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 life is but a dream, and that is a lie. That's a cute song, and I appreciate the wishful thinking. But the reality of life is sometimes the gentle stream becomes a raging river, and sometimes the boat runs into rocks in the riverbed and breaks your boat up. This brings me to the first thing that we must do to overcome hurt. Number one, the first thing that we must do to overcome hurt is to acknowledge the reality of the fact that we are hurting. I'd like for everyone to look at another worshiper. Look at them and tell them it's okay to be human. Those of you that are watching, I want you to put that in the comment section. It's okay to be human. The Bible says it this way in 1 Corinthians 10:13. There hath no temptation you, no temptation taken you, but such as is common to man. In other words, the scripture is saying it is important for you and I to know you are not in your struggle by yourself. Satan does his best work in creating the perception of safety in isolation. Don't miss that. He does his best work in creating the perception. Now remember, Bishop taught us that perception is a person's reality. Satan does his best work in creating the perception of safety in isolation. This brings us to the second thing we must do to overcome hurt. Number two, you must not allow yourself to become isolated. When we have been hurt, a common reaction in an attempt to prevent ourselves from further hurt is to isolate ourselves. And many times that isolation is from the very people who were hurt to help us be healed. Listen, we isolate ourselves from the people who were hurt to help us be healed. One of the adversary's most effective strategies in his attempt to take over our mind. Everyone lay your hands on your own head and tell the devil now, you will not have my mind. I want you to say it with authority. Say it again, you will not have my mind. And see, one of the devil's strategies is to make us think that we are alone in our pain, alone in our struggle, alone in the way that we are feeling or thinking. I want to assure you before we go any further in this lesson that you are not alone. How do I know that you're not alone? Well, the second clause of 1 Corinthians 10:13 tells me how I know that you are not alone and I am not alone. Because God is faithful. Oh, I wish I had somebody that walked with God for a few days that can verify. Have I a witness to that? That God is faithful. Or you ought to say something behind your mask. God is faithful. Number one, God is faithful to his word. Jeremiah chapter 1 and verse number 12 tells us that God watches over his word to fulfill it. Number two, God is faithful to his promises. The Bible said in Romans chapter 4 and verse 21 regarding Abraham, and being fully persuaded that what he had promised, he was able also to perform it. All over the building and watching on the World Wide Web, in your home, I want everyone to lift your voice, type it in the comment section, and let heaven hear you shout, God can do it. What he promised, he's able to do it. Number three, God is faithful to his thoughts towards you. Jeremiah 29 and 11 tells us that God's thoughts toward us are thoughts of peace and not of evil, to give us a victorious outcome. So then, listen to me. No matter what you have said, thought, or done, and no matter what has been said about you, thought about you, or done to you, God has not changed his mind about your future. So the last clause of 1 Corinthians 10:13 says, God will not allow your hurt to be more than you can stand. And he said, when you are tempted, he will show you a way out that you might be able to endure. In the King James Version of the Bible that we're reading, you'll find the word temptation from the Greek word parosmos, and it means adversity. It means affliction or trouble, listen, that God allows to develop our character, our faith, and our fidelity. I have to say, there are some things that God allowed that I wish and pray that he hadn't. But listen, saints, the presence of pain does not indicate the absence of God. And the human mind wants us to think the more pain there is, the less God there is. It is absolutely the opposite. Isaiah chapter 41 and verse number 10. Look at it in your Bible. I'm talking about how to overcome pain. Isaiah chapter 41 and verse number 10. Repeat after me, saints. Fear thou not, for I am with thee. Be not dismayed, for I am thy God. I will strengthen thee. Yea, I will help thee. I will uphold thee with the right hand of my righteousness. Well, I just saw an angel walk under the balcony from this side. Come across the back of the balcony there. God want to heal somebody's heart back under that balcony. Will you look at another saint in the eye? Because the power of life and death is in the tongue. And Jesus said, the words that I speak, they are spirit and they are life. There is a different outcome from reading the word to speaking it. When you speak the word, you initiate the creative power of God. And God said, let there be. I need you to make eye contact with somebody and go down in your spirit right now and tell them, fear not. Tell them God is with you. Tell them, be not dismayed. He is your God. Come on, saints, tell them God will strengthen you. Come on, God will help you. God will uphold you. If you believe it, give God a great praise in Mount Calvary. God will help you. God will strengthen you. God will preserve your mind. Sister Newman, Satan wants to use hurt to turn us against God rather than turning us to God. This brings me to the third way that we overcome hurt. Number three, turn to God and not from God. Turn to God and not from God. Almost finished. Satan tried this strategy of turning her heart away from God in the midst of her hurt with a young lady by the name of Martha, who was a personal friend of Jesus. Stay with me now about 5 minutes. I need to say this to you because some of us do not understand why certain things have happened to you. Why certain things happened to your spouse. Why it happened to your family. Why it happened to your children, to your grandchildren, to your brother, to your sister, to your friend. Listen to me. Satan hates those whom God loves. And he takes the favor of God on your life personal. So the reason why the attack is so great is because you are the friend of God that he will never be. And he takes it personal. So then, Deacon Reed, when Satan cannot get his hands on you directly, he will come after whomever or whatever is closest to your heart in an attempt to make you curse God. But I want everybody that's been through the storm, the rain, the hurt, and the pain, send a word down your row. I'm still praising God. It hurt me. It wounded me. It knocked me off my feet. It devastated me. It was a blow, but I'm still saying, Lord, I love you. Lord, I bless you. Lord, I thank you. Lord, I praise you. Lord, I believe you. I trust you. Consider this. Jesus interacted and ministered to thousands of people in his 3.5 year ministry, but the scriptures distinguishes three friends that he was intimately close with: Lazarus and his two sisters, Mary and Martha. I want all my friends from Teen Challenge to listen to this. Teen Challenge, listen to me. There were only 8 people that were prominent in the Gospels as it related to Jesus' personal life. Only 8. His mother Mary, his cousin John the Baptist, who was assassinated, Peter, James, and John, Lazarus, Mary, and Martha. That's it. When it comes to real friends, it's not how many you have, it's who you have. And you've got to stop trying to fit in with the crowd and understand, if I gotta go with just me and Jesus, we can make this journey. It's not how many you have, it's who you have. Hada shetomokose. I don't have time to tell the whole story, but the Bible says that Lazarus became sick and he died. A messenger came and told Jesus, Lazarus, and this is how he described it, Lazarus, who you love. Hata shemokotea. Hallelujah. Tell your neighbor, the devil is a liar. The Lord still loves you. Lazarus, who you love, is sick. But Jesus did not arrive at Bethany, where Lazarus, Mary, and Martha lived, until 4 days after he died. When Jesus got there, Shudabahase, tell somebody he's on his way to your house today. That just come up in my spirit. When you get home today, be looking for him. When Jesus, see what happened in the sanctuary was just a preview of what's going to meet you when you get home from church. The peace you felt here, you're going to feel it there. The strength you feel here, you're going to feel it there. Watch this. When Jesus got there, Martha's hurt, not her heart, began to speak. Martha's hurt, not her heart, began to speak. Mary just wasn't talking at all. She didn't even come out the house. But Martha said, if you had been here, my brother would not have died. I want you to notice that Jesus did not rebuke her, because he was able to distinguish her hurt from her heart. And Jesus lovingly reassured her, your brother will rise again, because I am the resurrection and the life. What Martha wanted was Jesus' physical presence at the onset of Lazarus' sickness. Understandably, she wanted to ease her brother's pain. She wanted to prevent his death. Stay with me now. Martha knew that Jesus had the power to prevent his death. But Uncle Chuck, what she was not intuitively aware of was the power of allowance. She knew that God had the power to prevent it. But she didn't understand the side of God that allowed it. What she did not know was that Jesus had already sent his word ahead of his physical arrival. And he had told the disciples back in verse number 4, John 11, this sickness is not unto death, but for the glory of God, that the Son of God might be glorified thereby. Listen now. What happened to you may have been fatal, but it is not final. I need someone that understands the holiness of hurt to look someone in the eye and tell them your condition is not your conclusion. It was fatal, but it wasn't final. Jesus did not say, he did not say, this is not going to hurt you. Jesus did not say that Lazarus was not going to die. But what he did say is what I am commanded to say to you this morning. And I'm going to go sit back in my recliner and finish recuperating. The doctor said, Reverend, take a couple of weeks. I want you to rest. I said, let me just talk to the saints for a few minutes, and then I'll go back and rest some more. But I could not. I had to pull myself up out of the recliner to tell you whatever the hurt is, whatever the pain is, whatever the disappointment is, whatever the disillusion is, whatever the despair is, you are here and I am here to tell you God is going to get the glory out of this, and you are gonna get the victory. I want you to give God a praise that'll make the devil mad. God's gonna get the glory, and you are going to get the victory. A word from the Lord was dispatched concerning your future before the hurt ever occurred. Before I formed thee in the belly, I knew thee. And before you came out of your mother's womb, I sanctified you and I ordained you. I want everyone to say, God knows me. I want everyone to say, God chose me. I want everyone to say, God approves of me. I'm finished now. But one last principle, how to overcome hurt. Hey, thank you, sir. When healing calls your name. I don't know what day it's going to be this week, but God told me it's going to be this week. I want you to look at somebody and tell them this hurt is about to end. I don't know what day
it's going to be. But the Lord said, tell my people it's going to be this week. When healing calls your name, God told me to tell you, get up and live. And when he had thus spoken, he cried with a loud voice, Lazarus, come forth. When healing calls your name, get up and live. A flat, John. You may have come to this service thinking that you were beyond the reach of healing, but you are not. Jesus, the resurrection and the life, comes today specifically to begin the healing of your broken heart and to give you the grace to recover and to give you life. And that more abundantly. Won't you look over and just tell somebody, stretch your hand toward them. Tell them, help is here. Come on, y'all. Tell them, hope is here. Stretch your holy hands toward them. Tell them, healing is here. Because Jesus is here. Everything I need is here. Jesus is here.
Jesus is here.
Everything I need. Healing is here.
Healing is here. Everything I need is here.
So what do I do now, Pastor Tyson? We worship you.
We worship you.
That's what we do. In our midst, and God has spoken. I'm not going to ask you to come to the altar, not even going to send the ministers into the audience. But if you will be honest enough, if you will be honest enough to tell the Lord, I need to be healed. If it's in your emotions, if it's in your mind, if it's in your spirit, your soul, all you have to do, even right where you're sitting, is just lift a hand to the Lord.
If we worship you,
that's why my hand is lifted. Come on, give him a wave offering. Be healed in the name of Jesus. Be made whole in Jesus' name. Worship.
We worship.
Thank you.
I want everyone to sing, Jesus is here. Everything I need. When healing calls your name, get up and live. Your best is yet to come. Help me celebrate your brother and your sister's future. Hallelujah. Oh, 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 praise. Feel the Holy Ghost all in the atmosphere. Can you tell three people you will recover? You will recover. You will recover. Type it in the comment section. You will recover. Minister Wilbon, Sister Huggins, Sister Hill, we are praying for you. Be healed in Jesus' name. All of the saints who have lost loved ones, be healed in Jesus' name. You will recover in the name of the Lord Jesus. It's a day of deliverance. It's a day of freedom. And it is also a day of celebration. And I hope that he is watching on this morning while we take a moment to celebrate the 91st birthday of the senior deacon of the Mount Calvary Pentecostal Church, the chairman emeritus, Deacon Charles Wagner, celebrating his 91st birthday. God bless you, Deacon. We wish we could be in Florida with you to celebrate, but the Lord give you a blessed birthday. Well, they tell me Mr. Arnold Wagner had a birthday on yesterday. Give God a happy birthday praise for Mr. Wagner. Uncle, I'm glad you're still here. They say great minds think alike, so I shouldn't have been surprised to find out that you and Minister John Austin were born on the same day. Happy birthday to Minister John Austin on yesterday. While we're here, help me give God praise for all the August birthdays. All you August babies, happy birthday to you. Let the church shout next Sunday. Next Sunday, we're going to be worshiping at the City of God, the former Idora Park. We're going to be worshiping there at 10 a.m., weather permitting, weather permitting. We want you to bring your chairs, bring your umbrellas, bring your lemonade, bring your Gatorade, bring your straw hat, And we're going to be out under the open air, weather permitting, on next Sunday. Keep your eye on the Facebook page, the web, or the webcast for notification. If the weather is unfavorable, we will have service here in the sanctuary on next Sunday, but our plan is to worship at the City of God next Sunday at 10 a.m. I want you to keep tuned in for announcements regarding our back-to-school anointing service that is coming on August 15th. We want you to get your kids here, your grandchildren, your family, whole families, teachers, staff, administration, so that we can put the blood cover over all of the saints that are going back to school this school year. You that are watching at this 12 noon hour that would like to continue in worship with us today, some of you are like me. I worship all day on Sunday. You may roll over after this service to Christ Church Apostolic Facebook Live, where the First Lady is delivering the morning message in Christ Church. Christ Church Apostolic Facebook Live, immediately following the conclusion of this service. I'm confident that she has a word from the Lord for you. Now, saints, we're about to go, and I'm on this first Sunday, I want to ask everyone, let's give God a tremendous, generous first Sunday offering. This is the number that the Lord has put in my spirit to ask you for on today. $48. $48 in the free will offering today. If you can, I want you to come as close to that number. But listen, I want you to put the number 8 in your giving. So if it's 48 or 38 or 28 or 18 or 8, make sure you get that number 8, new beginning, in your offering on this morning. And we're a blessed church because we are a tithing church. So we will always continuously honor the principle of the kingdom 10 in giving God the first 10% of our income and our increase. So if you're in need of a contribution envelope this morning, if you will lift your hand at this time, the ministers of orders will be happy to serve you. Those of you that are viewing online, the hundreds of saints that are watching around the world, I want to invite you to sow into this good ground. You see the ways for giving on the screen. Send your tithes in today, saints, and send a love offering for the continuation of kingdom building in Jesus' mighty name. The Lord bless you, heaven smile upon you, and the grace of God be with you all. If you're in need of a contribution envelope, just lift your hand. And we shall give on our way out from the sanctuary. I'm going to ask you to remain in your seats, and the ministers of order will direct you from the sanctuary in a organized, systematic manner in Jesus' name. Tell three people, get ready to have a blessed week. Get ready. Lady June, I'm glad to see you home. If anybody asks you, why are you so excited about this Jesus? Just tell him he's all right. He's all right. He's all right with me. Can you clap your hands? Everybody clap your hands.